Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. And for this video, I want to share with you kung unsa akong mga natun-an, unsa akong mga nakuha gikan aning pagtuon nako sa Ikigai. So, I became interested with Ikigai when I searched about what is the meaning of life in Google. No? Nag-search ko sa Google what is the meaning of life. Then, the word Ikigai, ningawa siya dito sa search. Okay? So, that Ikigai is a book. Okay? It is a book and it is written just like a research paper. Mura siya research paper kung ngano daw katong mga tao sa Japan, specifically Okinawans, no? People living in Okinawa, ngano daw mas taas ang ilang kinabuhi kaysa sa mga ubang tao comparing sa other nga part of the world, no? So ngano daw nga taas ilang kinabuhi, so daghan sila og centenarians, meaning daghan sila og mga tao nga ningabot og 100 years old, that is centenarian, no? So in the Philippines, no, reaching 100 is very, 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 very hard. Okay, so maybe because it is caused by our lifestyle, by the food that we eat, ang atong mga trabaho, especially kung dili ka ganan sa imong trabaho, dayon stress, problems, okay, especially financial problems that is so rampant here in the Philippines. So this book is answering nganong mas taas ang kinabuhi sa mga Okinawans, no? Mga tao nga gapuyo sa Okinawa, Japan. And according to this book, no, I don't have the physical copy of the book, but I made my own research, no? By searching it on YouTube, by searching it on Google, then I found that Okinawans have those secrets. Ngano daw taas ilang kinabuhi kaysa sa mga ubang mga tao. So meaning there are activities nga ginahimo nila sa Okinawa, Japan na na not being practiced on any other part of the world or on some part of the world. I mean, okay? So the first is this Mowai. Okay? See, Mowai is just a Japanese word which just means club, okay? So, here in the Philippines, we have clubs, okay? So, club is a group of people. It was established by people who have the same desires, the same interests, the same cause na ilang gina going forward. That is the club. But in Japan, Okinawa, they have what we call as what they call as Mowai. This Mowai is a group of people that is helping each other. Okay? So if one of the member of that Mowai became sick, they are the ones nga magtinabangay para motabang atong ilang membro. Then when the Japanese government pod manginahanglan sila og mga tao nga mohimo og mga public works and any other works nga makatabang sa society, mutap sila sa Mowai. Okay? So ang mga members sa Mowai, mutabang sila ana nga trabaho whether they are paid or not paid, meaning bisag naay bayad o kung naay bayad or wala may bayad, muhimo sila. Okay? So even older people on their place, no, mutabang sila sa mga public works sa nga makatabang sa society. Okay? So even if they retire from their work, they are keeping their life active. Okay? So here in the Philippines, when we hear the word retire, it is somewhat synonymous to the word relax. Okay? So in the Philippines, when you retire, then you can relax, you can travel, you can sleep, and wake up whenever you want. That is the meaning of retirement in the Philippines. But in Japan, Retirement is just a separation from your the private company or the government where you are working. But retirement is not an excuse for you to do some physical activities and to follow your passion and any other things that you want to do. Okay? So that is the custom and tradition in Japan. Okay? So even if the people are old, they are still actively engaging in the community through their Moai or that club. Okay? So the next thing is this Hara Hachibu. Okay? Hara Hachibu, it is a eating style, no, by the Japanese. So according to this, Hara Hachibu is just you are eating until you are not hungry. Okay? Until you are not hungry. Okay. Let me put this on the presentation, until you are not hungry. Okay? That is Hara Hachibu. In the Philippines, no, in some other part of the world also, we are eating until we are full. Okay? So there's a difference between these two. Until you are not hungry and eating until we are full, no? When you say eating until we are full, meaning our stomach is at its full capacity, 100%. That is full. While we analyze this until you are not hungry, or until we are not hungry, even if our stomach is not yet on its full capacity, no, of 100%, if we feel that we are not hungry, then we will stop eating. Okay? So if your stomach is at 100% capacity, the Japanese people only fill 80% of their stomach. Then they stop eating and say Hara Hachibu. Okay? So part of this Hara Hachibu is that they are using small plates, small vessels to fill with food. So gagmay lang ilang mabutang sa ilahang mga kananan, kay gamay ra man ang ilahang plato. So that is another technique, and it is very interesting, and we can apply it on our next meal. Okay? So try it. So especially those who are trying to lose weight, okay? Try to use a smaller plate for your meal. Okay? So another thing in Japan, they are eating healthy foods. Okay? So the vegetables, the fruits that they plant, they wake up in the morning, get up in the morning, then go to their garden, harvest what is already edible or can be eaten, then cook that food, no? They are cooking what they eat, no? They personally cook those food that they eat, no? And they are eating much tofu. Okay? Yeah. Tofu is a product from soybeans also. It is like soy milk, okay? So soybeans is being grinded, then it is added with water, then the juice of that is the soya milk. Okay, so katong solid nga nabilin pagkasala niya, mao na siya pabugatan nila para makompress, then that is now the tofu. Okay, so soya milk is not a product of dairy, it is not a dairy product, but it is a product of soybeans. Okay, so if you are lactose intolerance, meaning soya milk is good for you because it has protein also. Okay, so that is, they are eating healthy foods, vegetables, okay, so seafoods, then they seldom eat meat on Okinawa. Okay, so they are also eating tofu a lot, okay, as an substitute for meat. Okay, So let's go to the main topic of the book. Okay, so according to the Okinawan people, they have their principle or concept or idea or notion of Ikigai. Okay, so before tackling this Ikigai, no, let me explain to you what is this. Okay, so here in the Philippines, we are programmed by the government, I think, or by the society to go to school, get good grades, and then find a decent and well-paying job. Okay, so that is the teachings of the school. If we finish college, however, we have four choices. Natay upat ka choices kung asa ta mo adto. Okay, so the first choice is after college, even if you haven't finished college yet, you can do what you love. Okay, katong mga things nga maka palipay sa inyo ha. Okay, that is the things that you love. Example, you love cooking, you love traveling, you love writing, you love making or inventing something. Okay, after college, after schooling, you can go to that. Okay, and on the other hand, you can go also go to where you are good at kung asa ka maayo. Okay, it is not necessarily that you love that job, but you know you are skillful to that work. Okay, so that is the things that you are good at. It is not necessary that you love it. Okay, so another thing is you can go to a job that pays you well. Okay, even if you doesn't love that job or you are not good at that, you can proceed to that to gain a decent life. Okay, to get a decent pay to support your life and to support your family. Okay, that is a job. Okay, that pays you well. On the other hand, if you are not interested with money, you are not interested in the things that you love, and you have this calling inside you, okay, to help other people even without pay, you can go to that. Okay, go to the things that the world needs, no? I-provide nimo ang mga kinahanglan sa mga tao. Okay, so you have four choices, but according to Ikigai, no, the principle of Ikigai, or what you call that idea, is if you do the work that make these four intersect or has a common ground, then you have your Ikigai. Kung love mo imong work, maayo ka anang a work, makakwarta ka anang a work, then it helps the world. Okay, that is Ikigai. Now, for example is of this Ikigai is about Steve Jobs. Okay, so Steve Jobs loved to make beautiful product. Okay, product that is physically beautiful and is minimalist, then something that the world likes or the world needs. Okay, pasok na siya sa duha. Dayon, Steve Jobs also do that because he is good at persuading people, managing people, thinking about what other people may like. Okay, he is good at that, and then that pays him well. Okay, so upat ang nasulod sa iyang ginahimo. That is why he found his Ikigai. Okay, so he loved it, he is good at it, that activity pays him well, and the world needs it. Okay, so sulod siya sa Ikigai. Okay, even if Steve Jobs doesn't haven't finished college, in fact he dropped out of college because he is frustrated and nakonsensya siya na ang kwarta nga gigastos yang magginikanan, that is the life saving of his parents. Okay, adoptive parents, no, because kanang iyang mga parents pagdako niya is not his biological parents, no. Steve Jobs is adopted. Okay, so Steve Jobs is lucky that early in life, no, he discovered or found what he loves. Okay? So, but it doesn't mean na dili na nato kaya pangitaon kung asat atong ikigay. Okay? So, time is unreversible. Very important commodity. No? Kanisya ang dili na dyan mabalik. Once it is wasted, it cannot be taken back. Okay? So, proceed here in the elements of ikigay. Katong akong gidiscuss kanina. Then, it is an example. Pakita na ko diri ang example sa inyo ha on what is possibly my ikigay. Okay? So, the first thing on finding your ikigay, no, according to a YouTube video, is you must list those things that you love to do. Okay? So, I have listed here 3. Okay? I have programming, I have traveling, because I love traveling. But as of this time, I cannot do it because I don't have the fun and the time, no, to do it. But I really, really like traveling because I want to go somewhere with my family to discover the things in life, how life is so beautiful, no? I really love traveling. And third, I also love cooking because I want to make another dishes that haven't yet invented, no? I think it is interesting to make a food that people will like, okay? So, that is the things that I love doing, no? And the question is, mao ba ni siya ang akong ginahimo karon, no? So, it's a big question, no? Even for you, are you doing the things that you love? Okay? That question. So, there are only 2 answers. Some people will answer yes. So, they are lucky. So, some people will answer no. I think majority of the people, because of the education system and how society really, really connects, or how society define our actions, I think many people will answer no to this question. No, the question of do you love what you are doing right now? Okay? So, proceed here. And number 2, something you are good at. Okay? I think these are the things that I am good at. No? I am good at focusing. No? Sometimes when I am greatly focused on the things that I really want, I forgot other important things, other important aspects of my life. So that's how focused I am, no? By means of that focus, I can then focus so much intensity to a work until that I was done doing that. Okay? So example is of this is that I have compiled 960 pages of reviewer for criminology licensure examination. And I cannot imagine that I have compiled all of that during my college days, no? I am very focused on the things that I want to be done. Okay? I think that is the thing that I one of the thing that I am good at. Okay? So I am also good at cooking, no? At least according to me. Okay? Because I get some feedback from different people, but I think I need to improve it yet, no? I need some extra time to study cooking, and unfortunately I can't afford to allocate so much time on this activity because of my full-time job. Okay? So the third is that I am good at reading. I read a lot. I am very excited if I want to read a book. Okay? If I want a book, I will find a way to reproduce or to get a copy of that book. Okay? Even from PDF files around the internet, or audiobooks from YouTube, or audiobook from Google Play Books, from Audible, then even if I pay money for that, at least I am satisfying myself to learn something, no? I consider this as the third thing that I am good at. Okay, so remember the thing good here. It doesn't say that you must be best on that, okay? Because it can already and always be improved. Okay, there are so many place for improvement. Okay, so that is the second thing that you must list. Okay, so first listing the things that you love doing. Then second, listing the things that you are good at. Okay, so by means of this, no, so I love to program, traveling, cooking, and I am good at boxing, cooking, and reading. Then how can I use these things, these activities, so that I can pay myself, okay, without even working on the things that I don't like? Okay, so the thing that I concluded here is by making a restaurant. Okay, so because I love cooking and I am good at cooking, then I will make a restaurant. Okay, so that is the first conclusion that reached my mind. Okay, but of course there are changes, no? Humans are prone to changes, and even other circumstances can be changes. Maybe I can discover something that I love, something that I am good at in the near future. So this third thing may change also. Okay, so something that pays well. So the next component of Ikigai is that something that the world needs. Okay, does the world needs food? Yes. Okay, I'm making a restaurant. Then what is my contribution to the world, to the people? Is by making delicious foods, nutritious food. Okay, so if I have that business, a restaurant business, then I saw the smile on the faces of the people, the happiness, and the thing that I am making them full, then that's it. That's my Ikigai. That is the purpose why I am getting up in the morning and enjoying life. Okay, if I have all of this in place, then I will have my Ikigai. So that is the meaning of Ikigai. Now if we combine these two, the thing that you love and something you are good at, but lacking of these two components, then you have the passion. But we all know passion cannot buy you a burger, cannot buy you water, cannot buy you food, cannot provide for your family without discovering something, some activity that can pay you by doing your passion. Okay, so this is passion if you combine these two, but you need a pay for that. Okay, so you must find a way that you can get some money from those activity. Okay, because even if naani ni mong duha, ma-feel gyapon ni mga miserable ka, because you will be stressed on where to get money. Okay, kung asa ka mangita kwarta, dili gyapon ka mahimong totally happy, kay dili mo masuportahan imong pamilya, dili mo masuportahan imong kaugalingon. But you have the passion, okay? At least you have the two requisites for Ikigai. Okay? So another thing is that if you combine these two and three, something you are good at, and because you are good at that activity, you are paid, but you don't love the work. Okay? You are good at that, you are paid well, but you don't love it. Okay? Dili ka ganan sa imong ginahimo, pero maayo ka anak nga butang, diyan ginabayaran ka. Okay? So you have a profession. Okay? Something you are good at and something that pays well. Then you have a profession. Okay? Na kay trabaho. Okay? But The problem is, wa kaganahi, dili ni mo love ang imong ginabuhat. And some people, most of the people, especially here in the Philippines, are stuck in this part of the journey. Okay? So they are stuck on the work that they are good at, no? They are good at that because they studied for that, no? And they are stuck on the job that pays them well. But the problem is they don't love that. So that's a problem. Okay? So you will not live your life to the fullest, happier, and longer because you are stressed on this part of the journey. Okay? You will be stressed, you'll feel miserable, you will go on Monday, then rush towards Friday so that you can rest on Saturday and Sunday, or pwede nimo gamito na yung Saturday and Sunday to do the things that you love. But I think na kinahanglan mas dako tag time dito sa mga things na atong ganahan, di ba? Dapat mao na atong pagtuunan o oras. Ay our time on this earth, on this world, is just limited, no? If you let yourself be stuck on the situation nga depressed ka, miserable ka, that is your fault. But that is why I am making this video, so that you can realize some things in life that doesn't work like we are taught to be, like pariya ang ginatudlo sa tuwa. Okay, so next, if we combine these two, these three and four, something that pays you well and something that is needed by the world, yung gakatabang sa mga tao. Okay, so that is what we call as vocation. Okay, so you are helping other people while getting enough money to support your living and to support your family. Okay, that is vocation. Vocation. Okay, this one is profession, then this one is vocation. What if we combine this one and four? Okay, you love what you are doing and you are helping those who are in need, pero wala ka nakakwarta, and you are not good at that. Okay, or even if you are good at that, but it doesn't pace you. Okay, so you have a mission. Okay, you don't care about the money, you don't care about the luxuries. The thing that you're doing is that the important is that you love the things that you do and that you are helping the people in the world. Okay, that is what we call as a mission. But if you combine all of these four, then you have that Ikigai. That is the secret, one of the secret of the Okinawan people, this Ikigai. So they are finding their Ikigai in life, the purpose of why they are alive, why they are getting up in the morning. Okay, so they are making a purpose na mahabilin nila dari sa kalibutan. Okay, so maura to ang akong ganahan na i-share sa inyo ha about this Ikigai. No, if you have a time to read this is I think a very 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 good idea na that is worth sharing. Okay, thank you and God bless.